Hello everyone, it's Reuben here. You join me at Derby Station of all places. I am going to be reviewing a train that everyone knows as a vomiter. The Cross Country Voyagers, the 220s and the 221s. And it's arriving now, so I'll film it in. Here comes my train. 221129. I've checked this on real-time trains. And on the rear, we have 220022. Now, I've got to try and find a seat. You know how busy these units normally get? On we go. First of all, you'll expect to find accessible toilets, but we'll touch on that later. There's the luggage racks.
Luggage space
at the top. And loads of seats available, surprisingly. These are normally quite busy. I'm not going to film much of the journey as I've been having problems charging my phone recently. And I don't want to kill off the battery too much since I'm going to be riding this all the way up to Newcastle. So since I've shown the bits between York and here before on this channel, I'll probably film bits of the journey north of York. May as well mention that you do have blinds on the windows that you can pull down. Let me just demonstrate. We'll be keeping it up because I like to see everything out the window whenever I'm on the train. Anyways, some facts about the Voyagers. They were first introduced in 2001. On Virgin Cross Country and Virgin West Coast services to replace the HSTs, Class 47s and 86s, which hauled Mark II coaches, and I believe Virgin even hired a few 158s to do some shorter services, like between Birmingham and Cheltenham. Birmingham and Swindon, which no longer runs.
All miles to two, all passengers join us there at Derby. This is your slightly delayed 0750 cross country service route to Edinburgh. Apologies for the delay, we're approximately 12 minutes late leaving Derby there. This was due to us following a diversion route to Derby and then being held in
condition. Yep. Some of the cross country trains are going up the cross city today due to engineering works at Walter Wharton, as the conductor has just said. Yeah, so the Voyagers, 220s, which I'm sitting on right now, are 4 carriages long. The 221s are 5 carriages long. All of them were built with tilting mechanism. I believe the Avanti ones still have them, but the Cross Country ones had them removed when Virgin Cross Country was taken over by Arriva in November of 2007. Also, there are plans to replace the Avanti Voyagers with Class 805s and 807s, Hitachi IETs, and it is believed that those Voyagers will eventually make it to cross country. Presumably, they'll replace the last remaining HSTs they have left. as you can see, the Voyagers have Wi-Fi.
Oh, yes.
They also have electronic seat reservation displays. I don't think the seats themselves have paper ones on them, but there are also plug sockets on these units as well. Hang on a sec. We're on the slow line. No way, this is the fast line. Yeah, we're between Derby and Matlock. And we've got Pepsi Max Cherry. These units are quite rattly like the Meridians. Yes, these trains do have bins. I'll show you what the toilet looks like. There's a nice display of Whitmer, Wattmer Gate, the shortest street in York. And there's some mirrors and baby changing, standard toilet, soap, water dry and all that, and door emergency release. So yeah, what you normally expect to see in the toilets on the Voyagers, really. We're now on the bit between Church Fenton and York. Or Colton Junction, I should say. And the electrification is coming along very nicely. The wires are now up. Hopefully someday these will go all the way down to Neville Hill TMD. We've made it past York Station. And we're still running slightly late. There's a line off to Scarborough. And I don't think I've been on any of the East Coast Main Line north of York at the moment. I'll show you the National Railway Museum, which we're passing right now, but our passenger's currently sitting next to me. We are on the stretch between Thirsk and Northampton at the moment. Both 220s and 221s have a top speed of 125 miles per hour. And it's on this stretch where they generally reach that speed. We're just about to pass through Northampton, which is a station that I'd love to visit at some point. That line there goes towards Middlesbrough. We're on the approach to Darlington, which is where the oldest passenger route originates from. The Stockton Darlington Railway, which opened in 1825. And as for this station, I believe the current architecture was built much later than that. Sometime a lot later in the 1800s. We're now approaching Durham. There's the cathedral over there. I believe Durham is also where you can get passports from. I'll take a look at the now passing the Angel of the North, which means that we're near to Newcastle. There's first class, 2x1, that's seating. And I think I've got to walk through here to show you the bike area. There's also another accessible toilet near there. There is wheelchair space in first class. Just quickly, if you can, through the train. Cycle area to show you. So I'm aware that I am on the approach to Newcastle now. There's much bigger luggage. Nope, there it is. Now, if I remember to put it in, I will. There will be a card coming up from when me and Bradley were travelling to Cornwall in 2019. Which shows you that he did not like these very much. Currently waiting for a platform to get in. We are about over 10 minutes late. We were supposed to arrive here at half 10, but the train got delayed whilst it was going up the diversion on the Cross City line due to engineering works at Wharton. It's safe to say that the fact that I'm on the train that stopped on the bridge this high over the River Tyne does make me nervous, to say the least. Yeah, you might recognise this store from the Virgin Trains days. I'm happy to say that I'm finally off of this dreaded train, even though I actually managed to get a seat this time around. And it's my first time here in Newcastle. Never been before. I shall wrap this review up. So yeah, the Voyagers. The bits about them I like is there are about at least three accessible toilets you can use, which is very useful because one of them's engaged. And you've also got blinds if you need to pull them down and have a snooze or something like that. But the drawbacks is the seats sometimes get really cramped and it gets rather busy. And these announcements won't shut up. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to leave a like and comment down below if you like these units or if you don't like them. And subscribe for more, it's completely free. And I'll see you in the next video, whenever that is. And just before the video ends, there is one last thing I have to do. I have to say goodbye to my ticket. Oh, still got it. That's funny. I thought it gets swallowed. Like most stations, when you reach the destination on the tickets,